listening to the piece Organ 2, composed by John Cage. During the next 6 minutes, you will be hearing a fraction of 1 divided by 55,976,400, or 0.0000179% of the full composition. John Cage, who died in 1992, was one of the most important modern music composers. His compositions were often controversial and challenging, such as his maybe best-known piece 4 minutes 33 seconds, which consists completely of silence. When he composed Organ 2 in 1987, he added the instruction ASLSP, or as slow as possible. When it was first played publicly, the 8 pages of sheet music were performed within 29 minutes. In the year 2000, some people started the John Cage Organ Project, aiming towards following Cage's instruction as well as possible. They found an 800-year-old church in the German city of Halberstadt that was unused for a long time and would have probably been torn down if they hadn't found a purpose for it. An organ was built just for the purpose of playing the piece as slow as possible. In 2001, the performance started. The final note will end in the year 2640. Giving it a playtime of 639 years. The chord that is played right now started on October 5th in 2013. After being played continuously for 2527 days, the next chord change will happen on September 5th in 2020. A crowd of approximately 5,000 to 8,000 people is expected to attend the upcoming note change. I came to see the performance as a curiosity with no high expectations. But when I entered the hall, I realized that this is much more than a weird piece of modern art, and much deeper than any other music performance. Walking through the hall is already a mind-blowing and by no means monotonous experience. Wandering around, you notice how the sound bounces differently between the walls. You can hear how the waves extinguish or amplify each other, depending on your position in the room. It's a drone music experience of immense intensity. It's hard finding other projects that extend over such a long period of time. 639 years ago, the Europeans were not yet aware of the existence of America. They didn't even know there was a seaway around Africa. Arabs were living in Spain, and the Europeans were struggling with the Black Death. At what point will our civilization be in 639 years? Will people hop in their flying cars to attend the final note of the music piece? Or will some Stone Age cult worship the eternal piece of music after we damaged our planet in an irreversible way, destroying our civilization? Will humanity manage to keep up the performance? Or will it long be forgotten? After being destroyed in a nuclear war, will there be humans at all? I came to see a curiosity. I returned in awe, contemplating eternity and transience. Walking the hall, listening to that fracture of a note, made me aware of how insignificant we are as individuals. And how brief our existence is. It helped me understand the importance of places, that try to overcome our own insignificance. Once in my life, I will come back to attend the moment when an organ pipe is exchanged for a note change, to participate in something bigger than our existence, in something that will be there if our music, our instruments, our recordings will be long since perished, to get as close to eternity as music can get. And I will be grateful for its existence.